doing now, huh?
That building open?
We ain't gotta say shit.
I don't
shit
know what that is. Is that a bank?
As long as they seen us, the Lord gets here, then he gonna put that on at the same exact moment when the prophets tour, we're trying to give them the word. But they kept going. You know, they kept going. Or they might walk by, y'all stupid ass niggas. Get a job, motherfuckers. Cause that's, you know, man, we've been out here doing this for years. We done heard it all.
Yeah, well, until you think you heard it all, you hear some new crazy shit.
Yeah, something else freak you out. You putting the mark on these
that's
people,
good,
but this is
right
what we're looking for right here. I just saw one down the street, the cops pulled these two white girls over. One of them's bad, and you know, cops pulled these two white girls over. They didn't walk up to the car. They stopped behind, pulled everything out on them.
Damn.
They pulled everything out on them, man. I was tripping like, wow. You know? Somebody got the call. They must have got the call that these bitches up to something or doing something. They probably robbed somebody. You know? Oh, let me get the script for my channel. My mind go blank on it.
How long you been out here?
Not long.
It took me forever to drive all the way to the south side.
Put the metal to the pedal, bro. This is Ezekiel 9:4. And the Lord said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. Columbus, Ohio, since we're here in the midst of Columbus, Ohio, we can speak about what the madness we see here in Columbus, Ohio. You know, like I was mentioning before, the home, especially down here, you see the package. You see them, you know, and they say, oh, they ain't bothering me.
That's
it's
what
okay. What do they say?
They always say that.
As long as they don't touch me.
Yeah.
Nah, it gotta go further than that. You gotta condemn it. Because if you like, oh, as long as they don't touch me and keep going, you partaking in that same act yourself.
That's
anybody, you know? What you gotta say?
They about to have, because they about to have a faggot parade. That stone, what's it called?
That's coming up, ain't it?
Obama.
They got them a faggot. You seen them fly? Let it go one right there. The stone wall. You see it says stone well. What does that say? Stone wall.
Stone wall. Columbus, yeah. Something. But Obama made June natural faggot week or whatever. Yeah. I mean month. I mean, or some shit.
Dad, he was on the cover of Newsweek and it said the first gay president.
That motherfucker ain't the first.
Yeah, but you see how that was approved by the city. The faggot flags. This thing, if you put a scripture flag, everybody be, it's coming down.
Pride Festival.
No. That tells you how crazy.
SWC.
And that's why the Lord comes, because we're in need of a savior. You know? I mean, you walk through the hood and you got young brothers looking at you. I ain't gonna say bro, you got young niggas. I don't call them niggas because that's what they are, they're niggas. You know what I'm saying? The meaning of the word, why I call them niggas. They ain't, we'll call them black people too. Well, anyway, they ain't no brother, you know? But they looking at you because of color colors you wearing, blue, red, black, whatever the fuck you wearing, they looking at you like you an enemy just because you're wearing a certain fucking thing. Now, you what you about? Your 30s, late 30s?
29.
In your third, right, about your 30s. Now, come on, man. You old enough to know that's right. You know, ain't nothing righteous about that behavior, man. Not a goddamn thing righteous about it, man. I mean, you know, let me just get in the scriptures again.
They be repping their hood, even though they live in a fucking, in a pile of shit. You know what I mean? They be proud of that pile of shit.
The hood.
I ain't repping none of this shit.
God.
I'm repping the kingdom of heaven.
Good God. Your queens.
Love not the world.
And nor the things that are in the world. And that's the hood too. The hood too.
That's a big part of it.
And the clique these bastards represent. You know what I'm saying? The hood. And to the others, let me just start at 4 again. And the Lord said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the foreheads of the men that sighed and that cried for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. And to the others he said, in my hearing, go ye after him through the city and smite. Let not your eyes
damn.
somewhere else.
Yeah, we good. We good. I mean, you know,
it's a good spot to teach us.
Satan is the prince of the air, right?
Oh, you need some water? Need some water?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You know I'm gonna need some. Is this in there?
Yeah.
Cool. Good looking, man.
Yeah,
let's
throw
it down here.
Good water too.
You put this in there real quick. Can you put this in there real quick, please?
Where is that?
You put this in there.
Oh yeah, I got you.
Thank you.
Representing your rent. Okay, now check this out. When the Lord gets here, this is the 144,000 that's mentioned in the Book of Revelation. These men are going to receive spiritual power. Now let's see how much these no good niggas, these wicked hood niggas, let's see how they represent when they see men with spiritual power coming through with, you know, with their hands made of swords. You know what I'm saying? Because with spiritual power, you can do what the hell you want, you know?
If you read the scriptures, because pretty much the ancient Israelites, like Samson was like a superhero. He had super strength.
Samson,
you know what I mean? Even
Samson. Samson and Goliath.
Samson, right.
Well, David and Goliath.
That's a matter of fact.
But David has superpowers.
I gotta get it, man.
The scripture said that David killed tens of thousands of people with his own hand. You know what I mean?
He was very strong.
That's not a normal human can't do that.
Right.
I don't know.
There you go.
That's why the scriptures also said it were gods. Right. You ever see that scripture?
Yes, I've read that.
All right.
Hey, y'all guys teaching it, right? My English was always perfect, but that word perfect.
That's spiritual.
But they don't really know what they're doing though. A lot of them guys, they just real gullible, naive. You know what I mean? So pretty much, they no different than one of these churches. They set a trap for you. You know, they got a little cheese on the trap. They bit the cheese, now they caught. You know what I mean? So they getting got. You know them garments they got are not cheap. Them purple garments, they probably going for about at least 500. You know, so you know they made a profit off of when they sold this one.
Get a fat part. Hold on.
But like I said, their leader's a detective. How you gonna, the leader of your people is he literally works for the government.
Literally.
I mean that's crazy.
Yeah, that's crazy. I didn't know that.
Yeah, a lot of people don't know that. You gotta tell people. I got a scripture for, let me get that scripture, that detective scripture. Because the cops, that's all they do is harass Jay.
Yeah, because he got to actually lock Israelites up.
And he got caught in a scandal, too, where he knowingly got someone locked up that he knew did not commit a crime. And that they did there's an article in the newspaper on it. And that was because the dude sued the city over it because he got, you know, was wrongfully in prison. Then he won the lawsuit.
Because I was wrongfully in prison for somebody to do. I didn't know nothing of. I never went within miles of the vicinity where the crime committed. And I actually ended up serving like 6 months for absolutely nothing, man. For nothing. They let me out one time, and then after 3 months, they let me out, right? And I'm thinking, oh, they threw the shit out. Plus, that's what it did. Columbus threw it out, right? They threw it out, and I'm thinking, oh, I'm good. I'm walking. I know, actually, I was riding with some friends in the winter, like some dumbasses in a convertible, you know, and the cops pulled us over, like they saw three niggas in a convertible up in Crackerland, you know what I'm saying? And anyway, I found out I had a secret indictment on me put on them from Fairfield County. Fairfield County put a secret indictment out on me like I'm the criminal, and they arrested me again for the same shit that Columbus dropped. Sorry. Fairfield County picked it up because that's where the crime was committed, up in Fairfield County. And they locked me up for 3 more months. Damn. For nothing. Yeah. You know, and then they let me out like the shit never happened. You know, I couldn't get no record, I couldn't get no money for my job loss, this and that, man. But that's what this nation does, man. You know, that's just one of this nation's MOs, lock your ass up for nothing. They don't give a damn.
I got a precept for that. This is 1 Corinthians 6:1. Dare any of you having a matter against another, go to the law before the unjust and not before the saints.
The law of the unjust.
The law of the unjust is you gonna call the cops on somebody. You ain't supposed to be going to the cops. So you're supposed to deal everything internally. Yeah, right here, the brotherhood.
Exactly.
You know? So when you got someone, the leader of the church is an actual cop.
Right.
You know, he's in total opposition to the scripture.
The word.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Damn right.
I got his followers don't see that, so how stupid are they? You know what I mean? They gotta be, you gotta be retarded to follow that guy.
I got this on Samson though. How the men is gonna proceed. I mean, we ain't numbers a bunch of weak bastards right now. You know? The bodies get broke, we break bones, we get sick, infections, rashes and shit. But anyway, we're gonna receive power again. But Samson himself, like you were saying, Samson was a superhero. Now you saw the Hulk, any of them Hulk movies.
Yeah.
You remember the Hulk was tall as hell. Especially the first, they really showed it in the first one. Well, they showed in the second one too when they were in the park. And when he walked up to Tim Roth, and how Tim Roth was real little. Samson was huge like that. Sam, how tall do you think Samson was? 10, 11 feet?
He probably was
12 feet maybe? He was big as hell. We were all taller back then.
Yeah,
all of us were taller back then. You know?
Split women in half, boy.
Right. This is Samson. This is a big man. So I'm trying to find the case when he, remember when he went up to pick up the post of the city?
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to find it. It's right here somewhere. Because it was a spiritual thing that Samson, Most High sent Samson against the Philistines.
He hated the Philistines.
Yeah. because it came to pass at the time.
He got him. He got the last laugh. I got it. Hold on. Right there. Said a gate. What did it say? Gate or post?
Post, I think. Could have said gate too, but I know they refer to it as post too. I might be tripping.
Might just be gate. I think it's gate. I'll find it. Yeah, let's rip the city. You ever seen them gates in the ancient city?
I got my.
You know they had used to have walls. Uh-huh. They had a big ass gate.
Real tall, yeah.
He just went through a big ass gate and ripped the whole gate off.
Two of them. Both of them. I'm fine.
The scriptures also talk about how King David, was that in Psalms 18? He said through the power of the Most High that he leaped over a wall.
Jeez.
You know, when an infant city wall, he just leaped over it. Yeah, King David was the most mightiest warrior in the history of the earth.
I'm going to read all this. This is 14:1. And Samson went down into Timnath and saw a woman in Timnath, the daughter of the Philistines. And he came up and told his father and his mother and said, I have seen a woman in Timnath of the daughters of the Philistines. Now therefore, get her for me to wife. Then his father and his mother said unto him, is there never a woman among the daughters of thy brethren? Because the Israelite woman is fine as hell. Especially back then. That bitch was bang. You know? And the mother women, the other nation women, there might have been some beautiful ones around amongst them, but they didn't glow and shine like the Israelite woman. I mean, even now, in our lower state, you see some Israelite women just knock out. I mean, make you want to drop to your knees, they're so bad, you know? What's you that? Don't see it too often, though, because especially with the black woman, her curse is going to be ugly as fuck. That's why you don't see a bad, fine black woman. You don't see it too often, you know? You may see one nice and thick.
Yeah, they did. But they have a wicked spirit on them, you know what I mean? They all loud and disrespectful.
Oh, out of order. Is that mine?
Yeah.
Hey, what chapter was you in?
Judges.
What chapter though?
14, I think.
It's
hold up. Hold on.
16 and 3 is the scripture you talk about.
Okay, bro. Yeah. Okay.
It's 16.
Okay, I'm gonna get to that.
Alright.
Because this goes into some of his power too.
Alright.
Then his father and mother said unto him, is there never a woman among the daughter of thy brother, or among all my people, that thou goest to take a wife of the uncircumcised Philistine? Because of being uncircumcised, man, that's fact.
Yeah.
You know, it's gonna be for catching infections, not being clean. Because under the skin, is, you know, you can't clean under the skin.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah.
And speaking of women, too, they love to get with them heathen men, too. On the little corner stores, on the big grass. Just for a Lucy.
Right.
You know what I mean?
I used to have a foul-ass friend that went circumcised, and he would always tell everybody how his dick used to smell like fish. Right. And Samson said, said unto his father, get her for me, for she pleases me well. Well, she's quite pretty. You know, it had a foul spirit on it, but she looked good. Her mother knew not that it was of the Lord that he sought an occasion against the Philistines, for all the time that the Philistines had dominion over Israel. Then went Samson down and his father and his mother to Timnath, and came to the vineyard of Timnath, and behold, a young lion roared against him. And the spirit of the Lord, let me see somebody in this world right now. Let's see how I don't care if it ain't gotta be a male lion. Let it just be a female lion. Or a cub. Right. You know?
Yeah, they see a cub and they get scared.
Yeah, a cub or tear them up.
They get scared if they see a roach.
Right. And the spirit of the Lord came mightily upon him, Samson, and he rent him as he would have rent a kid, and he had nothing in his hand, but he told not his father and his mother what he had done. Killed the lion. Now you said 16, right? Is it 16? Chapter 16?
16 and 3.
So the 3, okay. And Samson lay till midnight. Damn. Oh, let me start at 1.
Yeah, it's all good.
Then went Samson to Gaza and saw there an harlot.
A hoe.
A whore. What, Main Street? Cleveland Avenue, Livingston with a man with a hose. Samson knew what a hose was.
Down on Sullivan.
Parsons. Broad, West Broad. Well,
down by his house, they'd just be hoes right on the corner.
Right, right. Day.
By the church.
Now, ain't no wrong with it. You know, as long as they
can.
Yeah, that's good.
Oh, shit.
Then went Samson to Gaza and saw there in harlot and went in unto him. That's the poor way of saying it. And it was told the Gazites, saying, Samson has come hither. And they compassed him in and laid wait for him all night in the gate of the city. And were quiet all the night, saying, in the morning when it was his day, we shall kill him. And Samson lay till midnight and arose at midnight and took the doors of the gate of the city and the two posts. The posts. That's why I got
posts. Holds the gate on.
Right. Metal. Yeah. It was steel. It was iron. And iron is heavy. Iron. You know, when you go to the gym, you want some iron. You know what I'm saying? And then he took the post of the gate of the city, took the doors of the gate of the city and the two posts, and went away with them, bar and all, and put them upon his shoulders, and carried them atop, up to the top of an hill that is before Hebron. Now he took this heavy shit up a mountain. Yeah. Now, I want to get the photo.
Okay, you know, the Greek myths, too, of Hercules, that comes from Samson.
Yeah.
That's based on Samson.
Yeah.
Even the Greek myths tell you that the Hercules come from the land of Phoenicia, which is the land of Israel.
Right.
You know what I mean? Well, it's that area. Because Phoenicia is really in the land of Israel. You know what I mean? So, you know, when the heathens get a hold of the stories and stuff, they twist them. You know
put
what I mean?
Gods in
they
shit.
Put their little spin on it.
Right. Their madness. Their madness, because that's what it is. Their madness, they're alive.
And you got heathen to start worshiping Samson, too. You know, his name means son.
This is help give you a visual, help you visualize. That's why we like showing pictures. That's why we like going to the internet. It helps put things visually in your mind. Like, it's like back in the day, the Lord would appear in front of Israel, which was a common thing, the angels, and he would actually give them a vision like they're watching this big gigantic screen TV.
Right.
Or he might have placed them inside the vision like they were in it, you know, like we hear now. He would. Now we're driven by faith.
That's true, because too, that's why they had the Ark and the Covenant up in the temple, and the scriptures always say the Lord appeared to them on the mercy seat, you know? So that's some bugged out shit, just thinking about that,
yeah, no,
you know what I mean?
Because
the Ark and the Covenant, that's some far out stuff right there, man. Dealing with some high technology, something bugged out, like the Urim and the Thummim.
Hope this ain't too bright to see.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry.
And the uniforms.
Uniforms.
And the girl.
You know what? I'm just going to show a small one first.
My queens right there.
Right. So you can. Yeah, this is just too
bright. Yeah, you can't see it. You got to turn your brightness all the way up.
By going to shade.
Is that what it is?
Yeah. When it gets like this, you got to turn. Then that kills your battery.
Can you see that?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
See, it was covered. at first, at one time. Had doors on them so people can't come in and out. Because when it got late at night, that's the world got scary as hell. So yeah. They shut them gates.
So you know, come in.
You know, but Samson, now let me see one person on the planet, the strongest man, two of the strongest men, three, four of the strongest men on earth go and take one of them. They can't do it. They can't do it, you know.
And you can see how even the animals used to even be stronger than everything back in them days. You know, they found bones of saber-tooth tigers. Right. Things was huge. The elephants was bigger. Everything used to be bigger.
What they call the elephants on?
The mammoths.
Mammoths, yeah.
Oh, they try to say, you know, the dinosaurs lived millions of years ago.
No. Most they got them
on. Yeah, that's crazy.
That's a fool talking when they talk about the earth. 164
But they say four billion.
You know what I'm saying? Then 100 billion years later, man started walking around.
That's just crazy.
You know, and then after that another 100 billion years, and they just make up shit. Just making up shit, man.
I mean, they don't believe, the people who make up, they don't really believe in it.
Yeah. That's why it always changes.
Because all them dudes, they like Freemasons, part of secret societies where they worship the ancient Babylonian gods. And had those secret devil worship ceremonies.
Right.
That's why they got Greek fraternities on campus. Right. So why do they got the Greek fraternities? If you want to go anywhere, you got to be part of a fraternity. And up in the fraternities, they sing the hymns to Apollo and Zeus and all that. So they believe in them ancient false gods.
Apollo. Those mother.
Everyone get that scripture on David?
I can get it.
Psalms 18. That's really called the Psalm of David.
Yeah, I was going to go just to the Mighty Man, you know?
All right, we can get
that too. It's pollen flying around. And whatever else we still got to find.
Yeah, you see
him,
he's spraying
a chemtrail
every day.
Hell yeah.
Yeah, you can't keep the sun up, can you?
People need to see the material.
Can't it just fly away? I'm gonna have to bring some weights out. Get some anchors.
Yeah, motherfuckers.
Oh well, so the only material you really need is the scriptures.
What you talking about?
18. We're going to David. No.
Break the bow. My hands.
Oh yeah.
Man of steel.
Yeah. Said in Man of Steel?
Yeah, though. That shit is kind
of
crazy.
Yeah, even Superman had a Hebrew name. Kal-El. That's Hebrew. That means the voice of God. You'll find a lot in them comic book writers. They just take stuff straight out of the Bible.
Yeah, straight out of here. Make movies out of it.
Yeah, Jack Kirby, the mastermind behind Marvel comic books, he himself, he said that he got a lot of his ideas from the Bible. You know, Galactus.
Right.
I listened to the interview. He said, yeah, the Galactus, that's the Most High.
Right.
He said, you know, Silver Surfer was an angel. He said he got it all out of the Bible.
That was always one of my favorite, Silver Surfer.
Silver Surfer, that's the dude.
Always. This is Psalms 18 and 28. For thou wilt light my candle, the Lord my power will light my darkness. For by thee I have run through a troop.
Yeah, by thee I've run through a troop. But the Lord give you power. And you know what I mean? The Lord will put you in a trance and you're just killing and killing. It's like you in a video game. You play one of them hack and slash video games.
Yeah.
And you're just killing thousands and thousands.
Right.
You know?
That's what's coming. And he ain't gonna give this power to just anybody. Yeah. Only his men that's doing his work, man. You know?
That's part of the reward.
The ones who are sealed, you know? For by thee I have run through a troop, and by my power, Yahweh, have I leaped over a wall.
That's what it is.
You know, now Michael Jordan can, you know, that was just a standard rim, that's a 10 feet? Yeah. That's 10 feet. That's
wall
it.
Wall to a city, you like know? 30 feet.
Right. They thinking that motherfuckers playing basketball like LeBron doing, they thinking that's something. You know, that ain't nothing. That is nothing, man.
Michael Jordan had to stop playing basketball because of his knees. The scriptures say that when Moses died, because Moses had power too, when Moses died, the scriptures said that he was in perfect health, his eyes were not dim, you know? Even Joshua was, you know the story about Joshua, how Joshua was, he was conquering all the Canaanites, He was doing a lot of killing too.
Yeah, read the book.
And he was doing all that killing when he was an old man. I think he was like, when you read the scripts, like 80 years old or something.
Yeah. 80, 90.
You lived longer back then.
Yeah, just healthy. You know, they didn't eat right.
I mean, Noah was what, 900? Something?
Yeah.
Wait, somebody, what's it?
Methuselah was the oldest man in the Bible.
Right. 963, 968, something like that. You know, something like that.
You follow the laws of the Most High. I just think that the earth was in the right order back then, went on this pollution. You know what I mean? They said, there's even a description in the Book of Numbers that said that the grapes were so big, it took two men just to carry one cluster of grapes.
One grape that's about this big was the size of a melon, man. And that's in the scriptures, you know? That's in the scriptures.
I can look that up.
Okay, I'm getting the mighty man.
Okay.
I'm getting the mighty man.
The Abba Yar.
Didn't Elijah ran faster than chariots or something like that?
They all have power. What's that scripture? There's a scripture too that said that when Isaiah, they'll run but they'll not be faint, they'll take up wings like an eagle. Even the North American Indians, because you know they're Israelites too.
Yeah.
And they had power. Even going back just a few hundred years ago, they still had a little trace of that, you know, because they was living in accordance with nature, you know what I mean? Because I heard stories that, what's the Sioux? What's the real name of the Sioux Indians? My brain ain't working right. But I was listening to this story. They said one of the Sioux Indians, through part of his training, that was that his father would shoot an arrow at him and he had to catch it. You know what I mean?
Right.
That's crazy.
They introduced it to manhood. It was rough.
And there were stories about, you know, the Native American Indians running for like, you know, 20, 30, 100 miles.
200 miles.
And they don't even need a drink of water. They just hold the water in their mouth and spit it out.
Right. I got that book with me, I think.
Shit, a fucking poisonous snake hit Peter. Or not Peter, but Paul.
Paul, and he
shaked it off. Maybe.
When everybody saw it, too.
Yeah.
Everybody was running for him.
Oh, yeah, dude. Yeah, right.
That was bad.
Yeah, because they had power. They was healing people. That's spiritual power. That's a superpower, you know what I mean? We are the Superman.
Ah, shit. Woo. Back hurt. I think I fell or something.
Numbers 13, and this is about the grapes. Numbers 13 and 23. And they came unto the brook of Eshcol and cut down from thence a branch with one cluster of grapes. And they bear it between two upon a staff, and they brought it of the promigates and one of the figs. So it said, you know, two upon one. They took a one cluster of grapes, put it on a staff, and took two people to carry it. You know, on a pole.
That's
big grapes. No, it was delicious too.
Yeah.
Just think that good wine they was drinking back in them days.
Exactly.
You was gone, boy.
Yeah.
And the scriptures tell you too, because our people, you know. If it weren't for Noah, we wouldn't have no wine, because it's the first thing Noah did when he got off the boat. It tells you that in the book of Genesis, the first thing he did when he got off the boat, well, he put up a sacrifice to the Most High. That's the first thing. But then he planted a vineyard, and he planted them grapes, and he got drunk. And it tells you that he got drunk, and he was passed out and drunk. But then Ham came up and seen him passed out drunk naked and started laughing at him, making fun of him. Then he cursed Ham. But yeah. And you can find too, there's more proof that the scriptures is the truth. Is that I was reading an article in the archaeology, I think it's on archaeology.com, the archaeology magazine. They posted a story saying that the oldest traces of a vineyard found on earth was in the southern Caucasus Mountains, the northern Zagros Mountains, which is where Mount Ararat is. Around that, because the mountains of Ararat, the scriptures say he landed on the mountains of Ararat. Okay. But right in that region where the scriptures say he landed, that's where he found the oldest vineyard. You can look that up.
Oh, yeah, I heard a little bit about
that. You know what I mean? And what did the Lord say about that wine at the Last Supper? What did he say?
Some
saying that's his blood, right?
Yeah.
The, you know,
and the bread is, yeah.
You know what I mean?
The body.
Yeah, that bread's going to feed you.
Yeah.
That's his word.
That's you know what I mean?
And the Lord also said that he said he is the vine, he's, and we are the branches. You know what I mean? But you're going to have people in these churches say, oh, you're not allowed to drink. When all the disciples were drinking at the Last Supper. So, you know, they're crazy.
Man, as long as it's lawful.
Yeah, as long as it's lawful.
You know what I'm saying?
That's a manly thing anyway, to get a little drink.
Well, strong drink.
Yeah.
But as time went on, we explained how we have power, how we don't have power now. Here's the answer to it. Here's the second answer, is 5 and 54. Now, we all weak and shit now. Consider thou therefore also how that ye are less of stature than those that were before you. Now we're speaking of our patriot, David, and hell, Israelites.
All Israel had power. Yeah, he even said Jacob himself. Jacob, the reason his name was changed to Israel is because the word Israel means he is a prince that has power with God, because he wrestled with an angel.
Joshua.
And damn near beat the angel.
Right.
He was whooping, the angel had a power, hit him in his leg, messed his leg up.
He had to use his power to cripple him, to get him off.
That's how powerful Jacob was. He was wrestling with an angel.
An angel, man. And when, Chuck, he wrestling with an angel, but when the angel appeared in front of you, you made him faint from his sight, from his very sight, you know? But he wrestling with this bad boy. Man.
And really, the angels are Israelites anyway. Those are our brothers.
Consider thou therefore also how that ye are less of stature than those that were before you. And so are they that come after you less than ye.
Yeah.
Like if you have a son.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? The son's never going to be you. You know?
But you can see that out here today. So you see how the men keep getting more effeminate and more weak. And as time goes on, they less and less manly, more weak-minded, you know? They're real soft.
Okay. As the creatures which now begin to be old and have passed over the strength of the youth, then said I, Lord, I beseech thee, if I have found favor in thy sight, show thy servant by whom thou visited thy creature. There's some hell, man, going through these bodies, man, with the fortuitous change of darkness. This is some hell. Ain't nothing fun about being these filthy bodies, man. I wake up every day depressed and shit. I gotta go through this shit again? Damn. All the pain. The suffering, you know?
Waking up's the hardest part of the day.
Oh my God, every day, man. Waking up in this shit. And then after the physical ailments, you gotta deal with the oppression.
Yeah.
These devils running around, they cop cars, you know, oppressing your ass.
I had to do a bunch of bullshit myself.
You ain't gotta do shit, man. They giving you a ticket.
They pull you up.
Then you getting taxed.
Bullshit.
You go to work, getting taxed.
Take all your money. And that's even unlawful against their own laws. Because you're not supposed to tax a man's income, you know what I mean? That was in the Constitution too. You know they don't even follow their own laws. Because the Constitution said that they ain't supposed to have no unreasonable searches or seizures. But they be having checkpoints set up on Friday, Saturday nights.
Yeah, they surprised motherfuckers.
But that's unreasonable.
Sobriety
they go all up in your shit, up in your everything.
Sobriety checkpoints.
Yeah, that's some bullshit, man.
Yeah,
This is 2 Samuel 23:8. These be the names of the mighty men whom David had, the captain of the night, that sat in his seat, chief among the captains. The same was Adino, the Eshtonite. He lifted up his spear against 800. This is one man fought 800.
I can't even fight two, man. I can't fight two.
You have trouble with one, motherfucker.
Yeah, right.
You know what I'm saying?
Jake was bad.
You gotta eat things, man. You gotta hope you catch that nigga with a gun. You know, catch him with a daisy. You gotta look around for a paw. Shit. He lifted up his spear against 800 whom he slew at one time.
At now, one time?
That's spiritual. Slap. You know, that's superhero. Even in the comic books, the superheroes don't even do all this. You know?
Well, the superheroes be gay. Like, Batman refuses to kill anybody.
Yeah. That's why I like lethal weapons.
He put you to death.
Yeah. I grew into the Punisher. I grew into, like, him. I ain't never liked him. I grew into my
shirt.
And after him was Alizar, the son of Kodo, the
Hey, he's flying everywhere.
One of the three mighty men with David, when they defied the Philistines, they were there gathered together to battle, and the men of Israel were thrown away. He arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary, and his hand played on the sword. Oh, the sword that he was swinging, he was holding so tight.
You know, probably had the imprint.
You can't squeeze no metal and get stuck. You know, that's spiritual power, man. That's rage also.
Yeah, it is that rage. You know, he was feeling. How I think he was feeling after that battle. He thought he probably had to get a drink after that one.
Hell yeah.
right. Some strong drink.
Oh, woo. Shit.
He arose and smoked.
The one with Samuel when he was fighting and he was thirsty at the end. You know where that's at? When he was fighting the Philistines.
Samson.
When they jaw and shit.
Oh, jawbone.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
Oh, damn.
Bunch of Philistines with a jawbone of ass.
You feel like thousands was that day or something?
Yep.
King David, there's a gruesome story. But that story when King David went out and killed all the Philistines and turned their foreskins off of them. Because that's that wicked shit the Saul made him do.
Yeah.
That's nasty.
Because that was wicked. He wanted, you know, but he just did what the king commanded anyway. Because he thought he was going to get David killed by having him do that. Because he sent him on a death mission.
And David had character. He had, he had loyalty. You know, even though Saul was wicked, he still believed that Saul was a man of the Lord.
The Lord had still put him in that position.
Right. He arose and smote the Philistines until his hand was weary, and his hand clave unto the sword. And the Lord brought a great victory that day, and the people returned after him only to spoil. And after him was Shema, the son of Agi, the Hararite. And the Philistines were gathered together in a troop, where was a piece of the ground full of lentils. People fled from the Philistines. But he stood in the midst of the ground and defended it and slew the Philistines, and the Lord brought a great victory. And the three of the 30 chief went down and came to David in the harvest time unto the cave of Adullam, and the troop of the Philistines pitched in the valley of Rephaim. And David was then in Hob, and the garrison of the Philistines was then in Bethlehem. And David longed and said, Oh, that one would have given me drink of the water of the well of Bethlehem, which is by the gate. I said, water had trees that was sweet. That the sweetness of the trees was getting in the water. So it made the water sweet, made it delicious, you know? And David was then in a hunger. And David longed and said, Oh, that one would give me drink, because he wanted to taste this water. And the three mighty men break through the host of the Philistines and drew water out of the well of Bethlehem that was by the gate and took it and brought it to David. They put their lives in the line just to go get the brothers some water. You know? And you won't see nothing. A brother won't even give you, you know, you thirsty. You niggas now, they got $1,000 in their pocket. You thirsty, just need a bottle of water. They won't give you a bottle of water, mate. And you know, they won't. What a case of water costs what? $4
They might steal on you for asking a stupid question.
Right. And the three mighty men break through the host of the Philistine and drew water out of the well of Bethlehem that was by the gate and took it and brought it to David. Nevertheless, he would not drink water, but poured it out unto him. And he said, Be it far from me, O Lord, that I should do this. Is not this the blood of the men that went in jeopardy of their lives? Therefore he would not drink it. These things did these three mighty men. And Abishiah, the brother of Joab, the son of Jeruiah, was chief among three. And he lifted up spear against 300 and slew them and had the name among three. Was he not most honorable of three? Therefore he was their captain, howbeit he obtained not unto the first. And Benaiah, the son of the son of a valiant man, a cuss of Kephzel, who had done many acts. He slew two lion-like men of Moab, two badass Chinese motherfuckers with swords. You know, they had skills, you know what I'm saying?
Shaolin monks.
Shaolin monks, right.
Moab was one?
Moab was, he's the, that's Chinese. That's the, you know, that's their ancient name. Chinese people, Moab is their name. They're not Chinese, they're Moab. Moabites. Oh, they're Moabites.
We call them Chinese today.
Right, but they're Moabites, right. See, this devil renamed everything so you won't know the truth. Just so you won't know nothing. And Benaiah, the son of Ivan, the son of Ivan, man of Kasdel, who has done me the axe, he slew two lion-like men of Moab. He went down also and slew a lion in the midst of a camp in time of snow. And he slew an Egyptian, a goodly man, and the Egyptian put a spear in his hand. But he went down to him with a staff and stick.
Thanks.
That's all right. That's going to keep falling. And plucked the spear out of the Egyptian's hand and slew him with his own spear. Now, that's some shit to die by your own weapon, man.
Damn. Hey, is that the one where I said your boy was, he could shoot that bow and arrow with both hands?
It might be.
And then, yeah, because then it was ambidextrous, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, right, right.
Both hands.
Yep.
You know, they probably train too, they know. Nah, Jake likes a train fight. Everybody think they can, like these days, all the Jakes think they're going to be the next greatest UFC fighter.
Right.
Talking about, you know, I'm the baddest motherfucker on the planet. You can't see me. I got the title. You want a shot at the belt?
I'm the greatest, like Muhammad Ali, faggot ass.
Yeah, like Muhammad Ali talking about.
He dead now. Dead. That motherfucker gone.
Yeah, that's a blessing.
He hit your boy with a snapping punch.
That motherfucker. He's proud as hell.
Because Muhammad Ali was an evil man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck what the media was supposed to put this nigga all over the TV screen. I don't give a fuck what he did in the 60s and the 70s. I don't give a fuck what he did. Because he's a wicked man. You know, he's a Muslim. A Muslim. You know? Bible condemns Muslims.
Talk about Muhammad Ali.
The Bible condemns Islam. Or any other goddamn sorry ass god. False gods.
I love you, brother. I love you. I love your swagger.
My man.
You, man, you are awesome. I miss you. However, this is my life. I'm about this, bro. I studied once in a school. I'm an Islam. I'm bold.
Yeah, leave that shit alone. This is what you're supposed to be.
No, but some I don't like because I don't like aggressiveness when it comes to Bible.
Well, what's wrong with that?
I'm talking about who has hate the next person or whatever. Should be no hate.
Well, look, if I did evil to you, you gonna love me?
Yeah, I am.
Huh?
Yeah, I am.
That's not, you know, that's... Put it this way. They twisting that. Love thy neighbor. Because everybody ain't your neighbor. You know, he's your neighbors right here.
I mean, you're supposed to be cool with everybody if possible.
Right.
If possible,
right.
You know?
Yeah.
Right.
But see, you be a stronger man and don't hate on the religion, but just let them know you got a better way. See, like them brothers.
You know what religion is, man.
You know, like them brothers coming out here with that purpose and all that? Yeah. I go out their neck. I don't play with none of them. I chopped the head off.
Right, yeah.
I told them.
The purple people,
they don't know nothing.
I told them, I said, look at him. All y'all help, get the fuck out of the side. I need your general, and I need about five of them to fuck with you.
And that leader carries a whistle, bro.
I know y'all wrong.
Yeah,
wrong,
the
wrong. Y'all bad.
They gonna blow the whistle on you.
It's
all
right,
bro. You got leaders,
man.
When I come around, you tighten up because you're better.
Right. Wrong.
Right. Amen. 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 Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's why all these people study. What do you say? I'm a Greek Baptist.
What?
He's not getting that. You understand what I'm saying? That's why he got up out of here. He's about to eat his ass up. But anyway, man, religion. As religion is made to control people. Just just like Islam, when wicked-ass Israelites come up with Islam. You know, to control them foul-ass heathen Arabs.
Islam.
Now, they expected to backfire them heathens to take it on like, oh, that's a real shit. They, the motherfuckers are strapping bombs to themselves and blow up the whole goddamn planet if they can. Don't they, though? You know? They didn't expect that to happen, though. You know? By Allah, Islam, nah, that's false bullshit.
I know the Muslims ain't got no truth because... How many Muslims we done ran into trying to talk to them?
Enough.
They can't debate you with nothing, man. They got no knowledge at all. You know what I mean?
Sorry? Well, I have no idea.
A damn Baptist preacher put up a better fight than debate than them. You know what I mean?
Right. No, don't, I mean, see, he's just trying to make himself sound like he's deep and full of wisdom. Well, teach somebody then if you got all that. Where you going if you got all kind of wisdom to share with people, you know? People say they're vomit. They come in the midst of you, they vomit and keep going. Because that's pretty much what they screwing out their mouth is vomit. Now, when you see a pool of vomit, you ain't going to look at it like, wow, that's nice. You know, that's pretty cool.
You got a spoon. Yeah. You got my spoon.
And that's how the world is looking at these people and their religions and their philosophies and their beliefs, you know, as vomit. Filthy, a table full of vomit.
And the tables are all full of vomit. Cause Jake's always an expert on everything, man. He's a master theologian. You know, he know all the scriptures, even though he don't know but two. And he don't even understand those two right. Like, I'm a child of God.
Oh, yeah, let me get this. Hold up. It just popped in my head. Jeremiah. You're supposed to curse them motherfucking false things out, man.
Right.
The dude was trying to explain to you, you're supposed to be acceptable and be nice and kind. No, you're not. You're supposed to curse that shit out.
Hey, let me get a scripture for that.
First of all, when somebody come up, you can be calm with them and cool with them and try and correct them. But they keep going with it, man. You got to go, you know.
You got to let them know that what they saying is bullshit. Man, right. Look, Galatians 1:8. But though we are an angel from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you than that which we have preached unto you, let him be accursed. As we said before, so say I now again, if any man preach any other gospel unto you
other than this Bible
than that ye have received, let him be accursed.
What's that mean, let him be accursed? Curse him out. Put curses on him.
Yeah.
Man, I hope that Coda bus loses power and just bring your ass up. You know? Because when the Lord comes, everybody gonna have either the mark that I'm repentant and I accept your truth, which that's gonna be few people, but the majority of the people gonna have in their mind that mark of fuck what the Lord said, fuck the laws, I'm gonna do what I want. I'm my own man, I'm my own woman, I make my own paths, you know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? I create my own reality.
Right.
Hey, let me read you this little part right here.
Okay.
Galatians 1:10. For do I now persuade men or the Most High? Or do I seek to please men? For if I yet please men, I should not be the servant of Yahweh Shai. So he was saying, you know, you gotta please men. And we ain't here to go along to get along. But, we will try our best, you know, we be neighborly. You know, we cool to people. So we ain't gonna be an asshole right off the get, you know what I mean? We try to be cool with you.
Okay. But you some people deserve that, yeah, which do. Already knew Dude Spirit anyway. I was about to just cuss his ass out anyway, because I already know he's a wicked nigga. Well, sometimes you can just look at a motherfucker and know that nigga ain't shit. You know what I'm saying? That's an old dog. That's an old G. That's what they call themselves, right? Old G's. They've been in and out the joint. Ain't no wrong with going to join if you know, because that's part of our curse. If you've been in the joint, you out now. I mean, that's just part of the curse. You're getting locked the fuck up. But a lot of motherfuckers go to join you. They've been in there 2-3 times. You know, and every time they go back to the streets, they always occupied and doing wickedness. Doing shit occupied and, you know, it's the shit they ain't supposed to be doing, man. They occupied into destroying their people, you know? End up in a joint. And so that's the Lord's punishment. You do wicked, the Lord gonna do wicked to you. Locking your ass up with a bunch of sodomites, because that's prison. That's the prison. It's a population of sodomites. How the motherfuckers in there can't wait to break the man. You know, that's
nasty, man. Yeah. Hey, they do that in the football teams in the high schools. Hazing? Yeah. You want to be part of the football team? They get you in the shower and everybody takes your turn on you.
Right.
That's nasty.
Yeah, here we go. This is Jeremiah 10:1. Hear thee the word which the Lord speaketh unto you, O house of Israel. Thus saith the Lord, learn not the way of the heathen, and be not dismayed at the signs of heaven, for the heathen are dismayed at them. Like that, like we was talking about Islam. What's their end symbol?
The crescent moon with the star.
That's right. That's right. Don't motherfuckers say look at the star and moon.
And it's funny you say that too, because a lot of the stars have Arabic names. Because you know that the Muslims, they was big on astrology back in the old Muslim days. But you know, yeah, heathens always get bugged out on astrology.
They see shit happening.
That's why I told you I met this girl last week. And she was like, she asked me what my sign was.
What's your sign, honey?
And she already knew too. She's like, I know you a Capricorn. And it sounds like, damn, this is a witch.
Yeah.
I was like, oh shit.
It's crazy.
I curse you. And then she's like, oh, we compatible though. I'm like, no, we ain't.
The hell?
Crazy. Yeah, she was going in talking about what the sun signs. I was like, I don't know what she's talking about.
Here you go.
Then she told me she was Kemet.
Oh, yeah, yeah. That's black. That's black people in the hood. Kemet. Come. This is Acts 7:43. Yay. He took up the tabernacle of Moloch, and the star of your god, Rimfam, figures which he made to worship them, and I will carry you away beyond Babylon.
Yeah, because you see it too, the Muslims, they got that Kaaba. You ever see they go in that, what's that, hijab deal, where they all march around and trample on each other?
Yeah.
What kind of crazy shit is that? But then they all go up and they want to touch that meat, because they kill each other just so they can touch that rock. Because they worship a meteorite.
Yeah. Ain't that the place with the tramp, where they got trampled?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think that's coming
every,
up again.
Every year they get someone dies up in there.
Yep.
And then
last
they have
year, the thing fell on.
Then they have a tradition where they throw rocks at stones and they say they're killing Satan or something. Well, I know all Muslims don't believe in the Kaaba stone either, because you'll have the Nation of Islam or the Moors. They're like, we don't even believe in that, dude. But they still crazy, too. They be wearing them. You ever see the Moors wearing the red hats?
Yeah.
The fez hats?
Yeah.
You know what that represents?
What?
There was a battle up in that's called a fez hat. There's a town called Fez, which is in Morocco, northern Africa. And there was a, because that used to be all Israelite territory back in the Christian days. You know, everybody was so-called Christians. Okay, they didn't, Christian, that's not really what we call ourselves. But the so-called Christians was all through northern Africa, Egypt, all that, until the Muslims came. But what happened is the Muslims came in and they murdered all the Israelites because their hats of war used to be white. And they dipped, they said, the story goes, they dipped their hats in the blood of the saints.
Oh, shit.
You know what I mean?
That's some love right here.
Yeah.
So, and the Moors, you know, they proudly wear those hats. It represents, you know, the blood of their own brothers.
Right.
It's just crazy, man. And you ain't gonna get me to wear no funny ass hat anyways.
Yeah, they look stupid.
Or wear, look like the Nation of Islam wearing a bow tie. Looks like Pee Wee Herman.
Fucking can't.
You can't pay me to wear a bow tie.
Oh,
I wear a suit on.
That shit looks silly, man.
Shit.
Gay suit.
Damn it.
The gay suit.
Yeah.
Okay. Bow tie.
All the gay clothing.
I mean, that's just an easy way to how, you know, once you get once your eyes waking up to just truth, man, you learn to recognize what you're getting.
What about your boys, you know? The dudes in the purple? They look like Sub-Zero off of Mortal Kombat.
Right.
Or Rain. What's the one dude's name, Rain?
Yeah. You ever talk to them brothers?
I talked to them.
The ones in the purple, what about the ones in the red?
I haven't seen them yet.
You ain't seen them?
The Confused people?
I've seen them quite. They're always over there.
They didn't want
actually, both of them. Both of them.
Did you? We tried to talk to them one day. They literally, we walked up to them like, hey, y'all doing? We got a couple questions. They backed up.
Ooh.
Why just a couple questions? They kept backing up, then they just
ignored us.
They started doing this, then they got in their car and peeled out.
Yeah. Where are they going?
They totally ignored us. What the fuck are you out in the streets for? What are you in the midst of the front of the people for?
Yeah, exactly.
What are you for? You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
We come up there and ask questions. I mean, what are you out here for?
Exactly.
You know?
Because they got orders not to talk to us.
Where the IUIC at now? They motherfuckers, I ain't seen them in weeks.
They ain't been out here in weeks, have they?
They gone.
Ever since they seen us the last time, we ain't seen them.
Yeah, yeah,
yeah.
They's like, we can't go back out there. We got to go to somewhere new.
Take dollars right there.
Damn. Damn.
That's a disorderly woman.
That's Satan coming by, boy.
Yeah,
it's like on the Matrix. You watch the movie The Matrix when that woman wearing that dress and the red dress walked by trying to distract you.
Yeah. That's big ass stuff.
At least she's staying in shape though, bro. Yeah. At least she ain't, you know what I mean?
Some homosexual she fucking probably told me she's fat. She gonna be out here much.
Probably not.
Shit.
That's why she stopped.
Oh, she did stop too. He got her.
She gave her.
That's her spirit.
She ain't gonna be out here much.
She's like, oh, I'm tired. Fuck this shit. She's like, I'm thinking, I'm done. Think about this.
She gonna be doing this for two.
That bitch look back.
Fuck that Edomite.
Yeah, running on this hard ass concrete ain't good for you anyway.
Right. This is Deuteronomy 17, I'm gonna start at 1. Thou shalt not sacrifice unto the Lord thy power any bullock or sheep, wherein is his blemish, or any evil favoredness, for that is an abomination unto the Lord thy power, Yahweh. If there be found among you within any of thy gates, which the Lord thy power giveth thee.
Oh, this is a good one right
man
here.
Or woman that have wrought wickedness in the sight of the Lord thy power, in transgressing his covenant.
Transgressing his covenant means you know, maybe following after these other gods.
And have gone and served other gods and worshiped them, either sun or moon. Now that's we're still in this Islam shit, right. You know? Right. Or any of, because Islam, that's who you was talking about with the fez, right?
Yeah, they wear that fez.
Right.
Hey, I think even the Shriners wear that fez.
Yeah.
And they're Freemasons.
Yes.
Right.
Yeah. We know what the Freemasons do.
Yes.
You know, there's actually Islam and Freemasonry is connected. Because you know them Ottoman Turks. You know, they're Muslims, but they're big time Freemasons. Because really, Freemason comes out of that Islam shit. Or when you get looking, well, you know, this is some complicated, it probably take probably hours to explain that shit. Right. It's all, really goes back to the so-called Jews, like the Edomites. Like the Turks. You know, the Turks are Edomites. You know who the Turks are? They the ones who sacked our city, Constantinople. Because you know what Constantinople was over there where modern day Istanbul in Turkey.
Right.
And that was the most, for 1,000 years, you know, from the fall of the pagan Roman Empire, the capital of the world was right there in Constantinople. It was the richest, most beautiful city on earth, and it lasted for 1,000 years. Until the Turks came in and sacked it.
All he's doing is telling you the history, our history.
Yeah.
Oh, here, look.
It's our history. In order to learn the Bible 100%, you got to know history too.
Yeah,
this ain't no, this is a history book.
Yes.
It's our history book, the Israelites' history book.
When you get home, look this up. Just look up Byzantium. You know what I mean? And you can see how, you just see right there how glorious that looks.
Yeah. You know. Wow.
But you see they was being wicked, so it had to come to an end anyway. I got this from the book loft.
$5. Right here, right there. You're talking about right there?
Yep.
Okay. Well, I would expect being there.
They stay up until like midnight, don't they?
11.
Oh, 11.
Where's it at?
Right there. It's on 3rd Street, ain't it?
Mm.
It's in Jordan Village.
I don't know what street it is.
It's on 3rd.
Yeah, but you'll never see our people in there, though. You see us, you may see us in there. But
now, we go in there, there's no Edomites in it.
Hell yeah.
There's women in there, actually.
Yep. He's Edomite women.
I'll be like, you know, I'll be fucking with
place,
it.
I've been meaning to go in there, man.
I love it, man. It's like you go in there, it's like a labyrinth.
You just go in there, man.
Looks like a giant fire hazard.
Yep. Drink some licking wine and go up
there. Oh, man. You
know?
I've been thinking I'm going to get kicked out sometime.
Right.
We be in there loud, don't we?
Yeah.
I can't, you know, I'd be all belligerent.
But, Farrakhan's a beast.
Oh, the honorable Minister Farrakhan?
Yeah, honorable. Yeah, that's an evil.
Oh, you know, he teaches.
Now, he sound good when he speak, though, don't he?
Because
he's good.
Now
his name, Farrakhan, means to sight, to you know, fire. It means, Farrakhan.
Don't Khan mean priest?
I don't know. Farrakhan.
Honorable Farrakhan.
Yeah, that's an evil man. That's a wicked man.
Now he's teaching Scientology.
Yep.
You know what Scientology is?
I know what Scientology
is. That come from L. Ron Hubbard.
It's
you can look it on.
It's right here.
Yeah,
it's right here somewhere.
And L. Ron Hubbard was a disciple.
They're right there by that clock. Okay. That's the Scientology.
And L. Ron Hubbard was a disciple of Aleister Crowley.
Satanist.
Yeah, he started all that.
Right. And
he got videos on YouTube. You can watch Farrakhan teach. explain about how he's justifying it.
Yep.
He done lost his mind.
Yep.
Like, he could play the hell out of that violin, though. I'll give him that.
But that's an evil man. That's an evil man. He's cleverly evil. You know, he's clever. But the Lord set him up to condemn two-thirds of his people. Because the Lord don't want everybody. So the Lord put stumbling blocks out there for people to stumble over, you know? The Lord don't want everybody, you know? Farrakhan. That's just how it is, man.
Hey, watching Farrakhan is some entertaining shit, though, man.
He's doing his share of help bringing this race war that's going to happen.
Yeah.
That's going to happen. Because he's inciting black folks to, you know, get ready, you know?
And President Trump.
Yeah, he's doing his part, too. He's doing his part. This is beautiful.
Actually, what Farrakhan was on Alex Jones pretty much endorsing Trump.
Yeah.
He becomes president, I think it's going to be a race war.
Hopefully before.
They already, so you see this hopefully shit popping before. Over there in San Jose in California?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Trump supporters getting the shit beat out of them.
Yeah.
I love it. It's beautiful to me, man.
I love watching.
I'm just sitting back, you know, sipping a little drink, watching, laughing.
What you, Mexican?
Hola.
Cuban?
They say Spanish.
That's a brother. That's our brother. But you don't see no brotherhood around here like we've been talking about. Let me get back to Deuteronomy. Let me start at 3 again. And have gone and served other gods, Farrakhan and his Allah bullshit, and worshiped them, either the sun or moon, or any of the host of heaven, which I have not commanded. Now I'm reading the scripture.
Hey, you know, Stu Farrakhan always got that clean shaven face, too.
Clean as a motherfucker.
He'd be wake up first thing in the morning. I got to shave this bullshit off.
Somebody's trying to shave him.
Oh, I bet he don't even put his own shoes on.
Yeah, somebody probably shaved him.
He's living nice, too.
He got bodyguards.
You see his mansion? His house is nice.
Yeah. I've been to Chicago, man. I saw some crazy shit down there.
That where he lives at?
Chicago, yeah. If he's not in Chicago, he's out west on all that land he got. He got a lot of land, too. It's thousands of acres, man. That he done got people that donated money and he went and bought land over there.
Oh, yeah.
When the Lord is going to destroy America, these motherfuckers are trying to build up America.
Because they think they can carve out their little piece of the pie or something.
Right.
They ain't going to have it.
Because the scripture says...
You see what happened to even Black Wall Street. What did it do to that? They burned that shit to the ground. They bombed it. They came in with planes and bombed it.
The military.
They said, nope, you ain't doing this.
Motherfucker niggas have banks and... they had an airport. Black folks had an airport of their own.
Yeah.
You know, an airport, they had banks, shopping centers, shopping stores, you know, just they had a whole community that they were self-sufficient from the so-called white man.
Yeah.
But the white man came in and destroyed that shit, which is beautiful, you know. It was supposed to happen, though. It was like, you know, it's that Amos, she is polluted. Y'all know what I'm talking about?
Like Micah.
Jeremiah? She was polluted.
Like Raji? Yeah, it's like Micah.
Micah!
Oh, yeah.
Micah 2 and 10?
Yeah, I think so.
Or, yeah, Micah. That's Micah. Yeah, you're right.
My man.
I thought you were talking about something else.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's talking about that
everything.
The woman thing.
Jeremiah 6, I think.
And,
2 and 10, just like the thought. Micah 2 and 10. Micah 2 and 10, arise ye and depart. Now, they don't sound like arise ye and build. For this is not your rest, because it is polluted. It shall destroy you, even with a sour destruction.
Yeah, because this ain't your rest. You're going to say you're going to build your own community. You still got to pay taxes on that land.
You ain't never owned it.
You can't even buy the land unless you buy it with the devil's money. Yeah. That means you don't own it at all.
That's right.
You don't own no land.
Yeah. From what I was researching on, like if you have gold, actual physical gold blocks, or wherever you go dig it up and you can get it melted down into coins or blocks. From what I found is if you have actual real gold, you go pay for something, a house, a car, you get a different title.
Yep.
Then the
I think they call it a colloquial title.
Right. Something like that. You actually do own. But like, ain't nobody paying for shit with gold.
Ain't nobody got no gold.
Right.
But he ain't got no silver, let alone gold.
He ain't got nothing.
Gold canker.
Yeah.
Gold.
Yeah, he's known the hook at gold. They got some weed.
Oh, they
though.
Got that shit mixed with other metals.
Yeah. That's the funny chain. Thing. So I remember back in the '80s, everybody was rocking gold chains,
yeah.
Like big fat chains. Right. You don't even see that at all no more.
I was. Yeah. Oh, yesterday I saw a dude on Livingston walking down Livingston with a big old Run DMC rope.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. It was some old school shit too.
You know that's expensive because back in the '80s,
he already had it though.
Because you know it wasn't that expensive back in the '80s. Now, gold, how much is gold an ounce now? You can't even afford it. It's so expensive. You know what I mean?
This is Micah, this is Colossians 2:20. Wherefore, if ye be dead with your Mashiach from the rudiments of the world, why, as though living in the world, are ye subject to ordinances? Touch not, taste not, handle not, which all are to perish with the using at the commandments of doctors of men.
God damn.
Which things have indeed a show of wisdom and will, worship and humility, and neglecting of the body, not in any honor to the satisfaction of the flesh. Because that's pretty much why these motherfuckers doing it, because they some carnal ass people, pleasing their fleshy minds, you know. Gotta go buy a brand new car, gotta go buy the flyest gear, jewelry, yep. Nothing.
Gotta have
like,
that diamond grill.
Yep. Jordans. You know, yeah, overpriced Jordans.
Old ass Jordans.
Man. Jordan don't care about nobody.
You know, he made it himself. What did he say? My shoes ain't meant for inner city kids. Let me find it. Let me see if I can find it.
Shit. Then he said he don't even wear Jordans either, does he?
Fucking faggot probably don't. Yeah, probably only. Oh, yeah, right. That's an evil man.
You see my shoes.
He's
bootleg
too. Yeah, the bootleg society.
I'm on year Black number 3. So we'll get him on camera.
Yeah.
He's a
fat.
Well, he's probably higher. He's higher
hey,
up
bro.
Now.
He's actually Red Wings. These is Red Wings. Look him up.
But when he was coming up,
Red Wings,
Secret
son.
Society, he was probably getting popped, sucking balls and shit. Yeah. From Secret Society, you know. Sorry. Ain't nobody getting through the cracks of the gate. Ain't nobody getting in that just snuck in under Esau. Esau got this shit locked down, man. He got it locked down because the Lord gave him this power to have this shit locked down. So if somebody in there and that's paid and that's on and you see them on the television, you see them blown up as if they're somebody, they did something, which is called the casting couch. They did something to get in there. And then whatever that something is, it ain't something God. We're talking about Israelites, man. Israelites are stupid.
Something
I got a scripture. I got a precept for what you're talking about. So let me get that. Matthew 6. And where should I start? Matthew 6 and 19. Lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. For where your treasure is, there will your heart be also. You know what I mean? I'm gonna skip down to 24. It says, no man can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or else he will hold to the one and despise the other.
Shame, right there. Yeah.
What is it?
I found the thing.
Oh, go ahead, read it.
This is quick. It's just something small. It said, Michael Jordan said, I make shoes for suburban whites, not poor black kids.
What? Wow, that's crazy.
Right. And that's where that people's hearts is in their minds.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of them Michael Jordans, because they line up for hours and hours for them
shoes. Outside.
You know? Yep. And then while they lining up, they might stab somebody, you know,
mm-hmm.
Or just to get ahead, right. You know. That's that wicked nigga. Just keep walking around, man. Look at us and shit. Right there in that car, right there standing where that car is, man.
Oh, I see, yeah.
You gonna see him come around there, he gonna look at us from that way. Maybe, you know, I don't know.
Hey, Eric, you got
him. Now he left. Well, he's probably going around with me.
Who knows what he's doing? Maybe he work over here. Now you gotta be on the lookout, though. He's trying to catch you.
Spies.
Got your boy.
We're running a pizza shop. Look up, good.
Say the check?
Nah. Yeah, he's looking at this dude walking.
He thought my boots were bad. Check them boys out.
Let's see. Gross. Damn. Yeah, so he damn.
Cheap Walmart boots.
This shit fucked up.
Who was that scripture you used?
It made it. You more bootlegged shoes.
Who was that scripture you used this week?
Matthew 6. Matthew 6:24. See, I at least rock some good boots. I know they'll last me about 3-4 years.
God damn.
What's the last one?
Yeah.
Boots.
It's about time. I'm on year 3. It's time to get some new ones.
Fucked up. Oh, shit.
The tennis shoes just fall apart automatically.
Yeah, I hate tennis shoes.
Tennis shoes are worthless.
This shit, Matthew's tennis.
Especially when you're poor.
Yeah. Look at this shit.
Yeah,
so
Matthew. What'd I say?
This shit, 6 and.
Yeah, 6 and 24, right?
Don't make a certain
master.
Yeah, that's it. I don't want to spit on my body. It's the allergies, man. Let him again right here. No, it was a dude outside of the car.
In the
suit.
In the suit.
In the suit.
That motherfucker just fell.
There's a bit of Jake for your ass right here.
Look a little crazy.
Look at your boy.
What's up, lifeguard? I catch that bus. Catch it.
Parsons to Great Southern.
Nigga look crazy.
This is bad. This is 1 Corinthians 10 and 19. What say I then? That the idol is anything, or that which is offered in sacrifice to idols is anything. But I say that the thing which the Gentiles sacrifice is sacrifice to devils, and not to the Most High. And I would not that ye should have fellowship with devils.
Yep.
Ye cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and the table of devils.
Hey, yeah, that cuts, yeah, getting along with everybody thing. You can't get along with everybody. You ain't supposed to be kicking up Satan and the Most High at the same time.
True.
that goes with a lot of stuff right there, like Christmas.
Breaking bread.
You ain't supposed to be celebrating Christmas. And that goes back into some idol worship. You know, in the ancient world, the ancient Romans, they worshiped Sol Invictus, the sun. On December 25th.
Spirit, that's what we've been talking about.
Yeah, because December 25th, that's the solar date. That's the, you know, because on December, what is it? On December 24th, the sun is at its lowest point in the sky. It's like the shortest day, you know, around the solstice time, when you get the longest day of the year. So on December 25th, that's when the days start getting longer again by, you know, a couple minutes each day. That's when it starts again. Because they consider Christmas to be like the new year. Well, not the new year, but when the days, the sun's going to be out a little longer now. So they celebrate it and worship the sun. That's what Christmas is all about.
How y'all doing today?
You know what I mean?
Nah.
What'd he say?
Say it's the movies.
Nah. I thought he said some boots. I do. You got some boots?
This is 1 Corinthians 1:10. Now I beseech you, brethren, by the name of our Lord Yahweh Shai, that ye all speak the same thing, and that there be no divisions among you.
Can't be no divisions. Yeah, we all got to be honest. I'm not gonna be like, okay, this brother right here, he believes in the virgin birth, but
virgin
I don't.
Birth.
He celebrates Christmas, but I don't. Or, well, I ain't saying, you know.
Yeah.
We got to agree on every last, even the smallest matters, we got to agree on.
Like, I can be against homosexuals. The other brother could be, like, on the down low and shit, you know?
Sorry.
You know? But that ye be all perfectly joined together in the same mind and in the same judgment.
Man, we all in the same mind, the same judgment. Because you got a lot of these Israelite groups out here. They all can believe whatever they want to believe. Because they just about a numbers game.
Shut up.
They think power, strength comes in numbers. Right. But that's not true at all. You know what I mean? Strength does not. We're called the elect for a reason. The elect, that's where you get the word select. The select few. Oh, let me, yeah, the scriptures say many are called, but few are chosen.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Somebody. What's up? What's good? What's good?
Can y'all tell me what y'all doing? And I could be off camera?
Yeah, sure.
This dude came up last time.
That's
what? Didn't he come up last time?
I never, I ain't been around in a long time. Probably like maybe like 6 months ago, maybe.
Okay. You look familiar.
Like, I remember.
You see us on campus?
He probably sees me.
Yeah. We'd be on campus sometimes, too. We'd be all over the place.
I just was always curious of what, like, what y'all be...
It's teaching the Bible, bro. Yeah. It's teaching about
Israel. What Bible? Is it like...
the Holy Bible.
King James, 1611.
Yeah, for the English, we use the King James.
But what we out here for is we're paving the way for the Lord.
You
ever read the Bible, man? You ever read the Bible?
Oh, all the time. I read all different kinds.
But you only don't read all different kinds. Just stick with the King James Version.
Yeah.
Because a lot of them Bibles is out there just to keep you lost and confused.
Yeah.
So you gotta have a solid foundation, and start with the King James Version. That's where you start. That's where your solid foundation.
And after you learn that King James, then you start hitting up the original scriptures, which is written in Hebrew and written in Greek. You know what I'm saying? Because really, to read a real Bible is really not in the English language. You gotta go, you gotta get your concordances, you gotta look words up. Because the scriptures say, study to show thyself approved. So you just can't just be like, okay, I read a couple scriptures, I know everything.
Nah, I never read anything of no Bibles. I mean, even the Quran, I read that sometimes.
I'll leave that alone, yeah.
You don't like the Quran?
No.
That's madness and confusion.
That's not a book that's not the book that was given to our people.
That's the book of the Ishmaelites.
Right.
This is the book of the Israelites.
Right.
Okay.
We are Israelites. We are.
I don't know what that means.
Right here. You're not a nigga. You're not African American. You're not black. You know?
Are y'all the same ones who deal with the purple shirt?
No.
Are the same ones who deal with the white shirt?
No, that's Peraza.
The white.
No, that's he's talking about Cuffy. No. It's white. No. That's Cuffy.
White and the red.
Cuffy's red.
Nah, we ain't ninjas. Nah, that's them. No, comfy people wear red and white. They all look like ninjas, don't they?
No. I'm talking about they wear the red and white garb.
Yeah, that's comfy people. That's the leader. Well, first of all, the purple people, the purple ninjas, their leader is a detective. Okay, he works with the police. So stay away from them. And the leader of the other white ninjas. He's the God sent comforter. He's the Holy Spirit in the flesh. So they're crazy as hell.
He's being funny. He's trying to say a joke by saying that.
He's just being a comedian.
You know?
They being a comedian. They don't want the word, not me.
Right. They don't teach. They don't come out here to teach you anything.
What do you teach them?
The Bible.
What?
By 100%, we're teaching them the scriptures.
What?
Okay, put it this way, that America's about to be destroyed.
What?
Isn't that Amazon? The Lord about America is about to be destroyed.
No, I know it.
Right. We out here telling
America is the serious Babylon.
Thank you, bro. That's in the script.
It's not a mystery.
Right. Well, yes, it is a mystery.
No, it's not a mystery.
It's a mystery to a lot of people. A lot of people don't know that. You know? A lot of people.
My confusion right now isn't scripture, but I'm a Bible.
Okay,
I know the whole Bible by heart.
You know, who's Esau? Yeah. Who's Esau now?
Esau.
Yeah, who's Esau?
I mean, in what sense?
Who is Esau? It's a simple question. Who is Esau? You said you know the Bible.
You talking about the devil?
Okay, now when you're watching a movie.
You talking about Esau the devil?
Yeah, right. Who is Esau now?
The devil.
Well, who is he now?
He's a people.
Okay, right.
A tribe of people.
Right. Who?
I mean,
what tribe?
I mean, we could pinpoint it.
That's what we're doing. That's what I'm asking.
But the difference is, do you agree with
me? I don't know.
Caucasians.
Right. You know what Caucasian mean?
Yeah.
What's that?
It's people from the north part.
No,
the
Caucasian.
West part.
Caucasian.
Yeah, they're from the desert.
Where did Caucasian come from?
Where'd it come from?
Yeah.
No, that's Israel. Jacob, that's Yaqub is Jacob. That's Israel.
We know.
The Edomites come from Mount Seir.
We know where Yaqub came from. It's Yaqub, in the Bible.
Yeah, but he
ain't
got,
Go to Habakkuk.
Habakkuk.
Nah, bro.
Go to Habakkuk.
Let's keep going.
You got a God and you got a Holy One.
Yeah, Jacob's a God. Well, Esau's
you
the devil.
You got a God and you got a Holy One. Go to Habakkuk.
But you know all black people ain't the same, right?
No, I understand that black people ain't the same. But the difference is that they raised us up under a book that they didn't give us for 300 years.
Come on.
Caucasians. Caucasians didn't give us this book for 300 years. And they didn't give us this book for 300 years. Plus, you ever read the Willie Lynch letter?
No.
No? Go when you get a chance.
Okay.
Look up the Willie Lynch letter.
Okay.
Yeah, I got this book at home.
Okay.
Look up the Willie Lynch letter. It'll give you a hook.
Genesis 36:8. Thus dwelt Esau in Mount Seir. Esau is Edom. So it says Esau dwelt in Mount Seir. That's where he's from. Where's Mount Seir at, bro? That's we talking about where was he from? All right,
come on.
He saw us from Mount Seir.
Man, the Caucasians was built in the same place that we from.
Patmos
in the Bible.
Well, that's an island.
But it's called Pelan.
Patmos. Oh, that's that Muslim. The two-headed side. Oh, he got it, bro. Then that's Yaqub. They try to say Jacob got two heads. And you know what I'm
saying? He was big-headed.
And then,
you didn't say that too.
And he gave me that book. You gave me that book, the history of the white man, where it said that Moses was black
was
and the Israelites.
Wrong.
And it says the Israelites was
but
white.
But I know the Bible too, so I can rip with you.
So you going to say the Israelites are white people?
No, the Israelites, real Israelites, are black people.
Because Elijah Muhammad wrote that the Israelites were white people.
Never.
And he didn't say
never.
That. He didn't say
never.
That.
We had the book.
We got the book.
Never.
He
never.
Didn't say that.
Never.
And he said, Yaqub created.
Never.
Plus that food Farrakhan.
Never.
We're
Moses.
We're,
the real Moses went
that
to.
We're the Edomites.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I know. Right. I know.
No,
so we got the book.
He never said
Farrakhan
that.
Farrakhan said that. We're the Edomites.
Never said that.
He
we
did
got
say
the,
that.
It's a video.
It's on YouTube.
We got
bro.
The video.
Never said it.
It's a video.
Never said
you
it.
You know?
We know the teachings of Elijah Muhammad.
Never said
that's
it.
Right.
Well, deal with me then. You know? I bet you I know him.
We build them right
I know
now.
Him by heart. Let's hear it.
Actually, the Lord about to destroy. That's what the Lord.
Let's hear it. I promise you, I'll destroy everything you're saying.
What?
You just said
everything you're saying.
So where's Esau from again?
Esau.
Yeah,
it's the
from?
Same man. That man from.
Where's he?
Where? Esau ain't my people.
What? Him.
He just read it.
He's not an Edomite. This is not an Edomite.
Edomite.
Daniel's 9, please.
Caucasian all goddamn day. Who is? You can label him what you want.
In 97.
Him.
He's Caucasian.
Oh,
I ain't Caucasian.
It's a brother. It's my brother right here.
Oh,
that's a black
prove
man.
It.
That's a black man right
in
here.
In what world?
That's a light-skinned black man right here. You know what I mean?
Daniel 9:7.
You can't spiritually see that?
Hey, let me get
you can't see spiritually in his eyes that this a brother?
A black man in spirituality is not like that.
So do you believe in the one that they call Jesus?
Jesus who?
Yahushua.
Esau?
Yahushua.
Yahushua?
No, yeah, his name's Yahushua.
Yahushua.
You believe in him, yeah, his name.
Well, I believe in him.
Yeah.
2,000 years ago? I believe that he came, and I believe that he's a respected man.
So you say he's not the son of the Most High?
Yeah, so are you.
It's good.
Yeah, so are you.
I'm gonna show you what he's
saying. Yeah, so are you.
I'm gonna show you what he taught there.
Yeah, that book we're tapping with, man. That's a book he's been given to us by a slave master and gave us the picture.
Okay.
No. They not only gave us the interpretation, they also gave us the interpretation of a picture.
Why did they call the Lord?
King James.
Half of the world.
Okay.
King James is a black man.
No, no.
What color is the Lord? What color is the Lord?
King James is a black
man.
What color is the Lord?
Yeah, he was.
You can build with
us. Even the King James Bible said
it's all built. All right, let's do this.
What?
We thought you can build
with
us.
If we do art,
right. White man,
where does
white
it start from?
Right.
From a
if it's a white man, mine. Why
on
does color. White man hate
what you
yeah, if it's no, a white man,
we do
black,
art. Where does it start from?
Lord,
black.
Where
is the end at?
It
ends
at
white.
Listen, the Lord Jesus Christ, when you call Jesus Christ, his name is Yahushua, he's a black man. So how can I be white man's book if the white man condemns himself?
He is condemning himself, but he's a lovely trick. He's a lovely trick. Why wouldn't he
expose himself like that?
Why wouldn't he? Why wouldn't he?
Why wouldn't he mistreat it?
So you tell me.
If I can get you to fool the world,
okay.
Why wouldn't I give you something that would make sense to you?
Why would the devil do that? Why would the devil give you 100% truth?
It makes sense. 100%? Never. That's,
okay, how? Prove it. Prove it.
Never.
Prove it.
That's what I'm pressing.
Prove it. What's false? What's false?
What's false?
Yeah.
Jesus never died on the cross.
7 billion people.
Prove it. Prove it. Prove that Jesus died on the cross.
It's freaking, this historic.
Prove it.
This historic.
Prove it.
This is historic. What's
prove
they call it?
It.
I was with that counts. This is historic.
Prove
that
it.
Counts.
Prove
ever,
it.
What's
prove
the
it.
Polite.
The homo.
Prove it.
Hold on,
prove it.
There's so many people talking,
what's,
bro.
What's that Roman dude? Pilate.
Hey, here we go.
Okay, wait.
Let's get some
this
order.
Malachi 1:1. Malachi 1:1. The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi. I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet he say, wherein hast thou loved us? Was not Esau Jacob's brother? Saith the Lord, yet I love Jacob. And I hated Esau.
Lord
so
hated
this is a white man's book. Why would the white, why didn't he take this? Why didn't he put that in there?
That the Lord hate him. The devil will fool the world. The devil will fool the world.
Okay, why would he say?
Why wouldn't he fool the world by the greatest book in the world?
So why would he call Jesus Christ a white man?
Why
but
he fool
listen,
the world
listen,
by the greatest
listen,
book in the
listen.
World?
They call Jesus Christ a white man, but in the Bible it says he's black.
Right.
What
so
sense
what?
Does that make?
That is actually a book that was not written by the people that we know. That is the book that has been translated.
Psalm 105.
You
got I am
King
black.
James Bible?
Yeah.
All right, go where you go to Genesis.
No,
go
to
he said, what scripture is
it? Song of Solomon 105.
Song of Solomon 105.
It says,
Genesis
I am black.
Five.
Right.
So this
Genesis
is a white
chapter 5.
Hold up,
guess what it say?
This is a white man's book,
King James Bible.
King James was a black man.
Same one you talking about. It say Adam. Now, if you keep going on with the Bibles, they've been translated and translated.
We don't deal with those, man.
Translated. Guess what it say? It says something whole different.
We don't deal with those translations.
We don't deal with all that.
Humankind. It don't say
you
Adam.
You gotta go to the Greek and Hebrew.
Bro, I done been to the Greek and Hebrew. I done read the Bible concordantly.
Bro, we just said we only deal with King James Version. That's all. Yeah. We been said that. Mm-hmm.
No,
would you
ain't
listen?
Been said nothing. Nobody said it.
I
just said it.
The first day, the first time you.
Well, I wasn't here when you said it.
Okay.
I wasn't here when
well,
you
look,
said
okay, I'm going to tell you again.
I wasn't here when you said
that's why he got King James.
I wasn't here
I got
when
a King
it.
James.
Well, go to Genesis chapter 5.
Let me read this real
go to Genesis chapter 5.
3, 1-13.
Go to Genesis chapter 5.
In the midst of the seven candlesticks,
Genesis chapter
one
five,
like unto the Son of Man,
Adam
clothed with a garment down to the foot,
and
a girdle about the paps with a garden girdle.
It says that Adam is the male and the female.
And his hairs were white like wool.
So the Bible says the Lord's hair was had woolly hair. All
right.
So that's a white man's book.
And as white as snow.
Yes.
And his eyes were
but
as
they gave
of
another
fight.
Picture of it.
But why would he?
And his feet.
There ain't no pictures in this book.
No, not
feet,
in this book.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
Bro, you've been deceived, bro.
As if burnt
who?
In a furnace.
Satan?
Yeah, I know. We have
so
been.
How in the hell the white
I
like
ain't
the
been.
Book, but they're going to describe the Lord as
but
being
you said,
a black man.
That don't make no sense.
We have been.
Brass.
But didn't tell
but
it,
I
he's white.
Been.
Anybody got a penny on you?
We have been, but I haven't
put that brass in a fight. What happens with the brass?
We have been,
it gets
but I haven't
darker.
Been.
It gets darker.
We have
so
been,
is this
but
a white
I haven't
man's
been.
Book?
That don't make no sense.
Man, that don't make no sense because the same book that you got.
He don't believe in
white,
the book anyway.
No, no, yeah, let's
wait,
stop here.
What?
The same book you got is for 300 years we couldn't have.
Oh, wait, I'm
can I say
and then they
wrong,
gave
bro.
You the book.
I've been listening to y'all and folks doing the same things y'all doing online and different places around the country. The truth is getting out there. Keep doing what you're doing. It's reaching folks, man.
That's right.
I'm hearing you.
That's right.
And you know, I've been doing some studying on my own. God bless y'all. Keep doing what you're doing.
All right. This is
Next time I see y'all, I'm gonna have a book with me, and I'm gonna make sure I show you the same thing. But at the same time, we gotta be an interpretation. The Bible is interpreted by whoever it was interpreted by. You know what allegories is? Do you know what allegories is?
I do know this.
Do you know what allegories is?
Of course I do.
Allegories are something that you can be able to interpret at any moment with your own interpretation.
There's no private interpretation. That's
private interpretation. Exactly.
It's
private interpretation. Exactly. You're right.
Now let's all sit down and
no, it ain't no fact of false.
It says no private interpretation.
Allegories is not no fact of false. Allegories is
a private interpretation.
But let's interpret this.
I wish y'all find something common about that y'all can agree on.
The Lord loves division.
That ain't gonna happen.
The Lord loves that.
That ain't never gonna happen.
Because majority, 2/3 of our people are gone.
You ain't even building the way the other people.
1/3 of our people eyes are open.
Okay.
One third.
Many are called, but few are chosen.
The scripture say love
you.
Israel.
Yeah. You.
But you got a lot of joy in your spirit.
Okay.
And I can see it in your eyes.
How long?
Your Lord is going to give you what you need.
Okay.
He gonna put it in
so what about you?
He's going to wake up on this guy.
Too late for him.
What about you?
Let me show you this.
He ain't wet.
Let me hold
okay.
up.
It's going to be too late. Hold
up. My girl. I remember you.
Remember, 2/3 of our people are... Let me just get it.
When you say 2/3 of our people, you mean Israel, black people.
Black, Latinos, and Native Americans.
Well, remember, our people don't look like some of our people don't look like our people.
Hello.
Obviously.
Hey, brother, let me read your description,
you know,
brother.
Because I ain't gonna let no motherfucking fool come up here and say my brother in the Israelite.
I ain't worried about this dude crazy. Hey, but let me read the description for you, brother. Look at this, because you said how we're going to find some common ground, right?
Yeah.
Well, this is what this is red letters right here. This is Luke 12 and 51. Suppose ye that I am come to give peace on earth. I tell you nay, but rather division.
Now, red letters.
That's Jesus.
Red letter, right?
What, now, yeah. What did you just
okay.
see?
Okay.
What did you just see?
Beautiful.
Division.
Yeah.
Division. the Lord ain't no lie. See what I'm saying?
Here we go. Zechariah 13 and 8. And it shall come to pass that in all the land, saith the Lord, two parts therein shall be cut off and die. But the third shall be left therein.
What book is that?
That's Zechariah.
Zechariah.
You know, precept upon precept. Here a little and there a little.
Revelation breaks out how it's done, huh?
Yeah.
Breaks out down.
See, people can come out here and argue all they want. I read this.
He just sounded crazy as hell.
Mm-hmm. Sounded ridiculous.
Beyond ridiculous. That was ludicrous.
Right. So much madness, he don't know what he's vomiting up. But he's vomiting
I
a lot.
I just shared with you guys some
what's that?
Yeah,
right about
yeah, I can't wait to go over it though.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, we got there's well, we in a time of truth, all kind of truth is coming out.
Yeah,
right. Hey, this time.
Bring the same Bible.
Hey, I'm gonna bring that. I'm gonna bring Elijah Muhammad's book.
Yeah.
I got it, bro.
But I'm gonna bring my own.
We're gonna be here next Sunday.
You might have got it from somewhere else, and it ain't mine. Ain't tampered with. But respect.
Yep.
Respect. Y'all be peaceful.
Be here next Sunday, same time.
Peace.
Hey, man, I just tried to be.
Do like right. That's nasty, bro.
That's a gift, bro. Every time I pray the Most High, that's a little gift, you know what I mean? I pray to the Lord for moments like that, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because all that does is just further prove to what we're saying is true. And everybody else is crazy as hell.
Spirits blitzing at the same time, though.
I praise
the trying to overwhelm you and shit.
Oh, praise you, how about some of your son?
And that tells you when spirits work together, because they be all come at one time.
They do, yeah, they do, don't they?
Yeah. Not in parts, it's all one time.
It's meant to get you all.
She got all kind of questions.
Let me read this for her first real quick. This is 2 Peter 1 and 20. Knowing this first, that no prophecy of the scripture is of any private interpretation. That's what you want.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, here we go, biologists.
In the Bible, the Dominicans, like, these are the same people?
Well, Israel's, yeah. I mean, we can go in on it. But Israel scattered among all nations as well, though. Because you got larger concentrations of Israelites in certain areas, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Just to clarify, like, the people on this side, in the Bible.
Where are you from? You look like a Levite or something.
Oh, okay.
Are you?
Who are you from?
You Haitian?
I don't know.
You're here in America. Columbus.
What's your nationality?
Huh?
What's your nationality?
I'm Black American.
Oh, okay.
So, I don't know anything about my ancestors.
Yeah, you're a British.
I didn't know that.
Okay. mixed up. The locations they are at this moment is where they were in the Bible.
No.
Okay, that's not what that is. Okay, so they, that's where their people, like their ancestors came from those spots and then they like,
so that's part of the curses. And we're not in our own land no more. You know what I'm saying?
Slavery.
Because Israel is a people before it's a place.
That one, slave ships, Deuteronomy 28.
Because why that was written before slavery started. So
that's why you just said that. Yeah. I get that Deuteronomy 28, 68.
We don't get it anyway.
That's my girl.
Cooler now, I guess.
Yeah, last week she out here. She was trying to cuss us out.
Yeah. She was a scientist.
She seen us get it in, bro. She's like, I ain't messing with him today.
This is Deuteronomy 28:16. The Lord shall bring thee into Egypt.
Yeah, that's
the
limb. That came all over the place.
Yeah. Yeah, motherfucker.
That thing's still going. You got a super battery in that one.
Right. Go for the heavy spear.
Shit.
Seems like that one's been going for a minute too.
Yeah, got one more left.
One little bar?
Yeah.
I had an SD card to go out before the battery.
Sorry.
That's right. I can't wait to go through this though. Whatever. Man, is this
good? What's that?
I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
Nigga,
that dude was cool though, wasn't he?
Yeah, he was cool, but he gone.
Man, yeah, you know, but.
Oh, shit. The thing about them mixed, you know, the scattered among all nations, stuff like that.
Yeah.
And during slavery, the so-called Negroes went to the Seminole Indians, and they had sex with them. They, you know, they had children.
Yeah, you got shit. Israel scattered within Israel too.
Yeah. So they,
you know,
they
what
mixed.
I mean, you might have Benjamites thinking they a Judah.
Just like she go to my school.
I see a whole lot of that.
Yeah, you see, like, right? Because she looked to me like she was Haitian or something.
A lot of Judahites think they're Benjamites.
Yep.
A whole lot of, like, every tribe think they Native American.
Yeah, they do. Everybody want to be. Everybody's dead. Every
tribe. I'm a big player.
Everybody want to be Native American.
On their mother's side and shit. I think
remember,
I know
you used to
that
watch them do they do that DNA test and none of us did.
Right.
But even though that's bullshit though, you can't trust those DNA tests. Because nobody has a DNA of Jacob. You know what I mean?
See, like I always say, that nigga, basketball player, Blake Griffin, his dad's black as fuck, blacker than all of us.
And then
he got a white girl. And then, you know, Blake Griffin's light-skinned, and then he got with a white girl, and this son got blue eyes, and he looked like straight up a white boy.
Just like a white boy.
Oh, what a, yeah. And everybody loves Bob Marley, don't they?
Oh, shit.
Everybody loved Bob Marley. They say Bob Marley was a prophet. Well, his dad was a Scotsman. His dad, was he Scottish? His dad was a white man.
Damn.
Well, he wasn't a white, I tell you, his dad was an Israelite.
Yeah.
He was not, you know, he's not an Edomite.
Well, definitely
a Jake. Because you're going to say Bob Marley ain't an Israelite. You're something wrong with your brain. You know what I mean?
I knew that.
Something just ain't right with your whole spirit. Because Bob Marley was getting it in.
Ain't Farrakhan's dad white?
Farrakhan's dad, he was black.
Oh.
Was he?
Black as hell.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Malcolm X had red hair. I guess he was red like Esau, too.
Yeah. Rudy.
Back to the note, this scripture talk about outward appearance.
So, y'all.
What do we serve?
This motherfucker. Dude, I think that. Let's go to my school. Can't get a number now.
Hey, that's why I live for this, man. Do you want to get crazy? That's my favorite moment.
Hell yeah.
I love it, bro.
You just go home and learn all this on your own. You have to be taught by brothers.
And the thing about teaching out here, too, because we learn by teaching. You know what I mean? Because we're still learning.
Yeah.
And every time something crazy happens like that, that's a learning experience each time. Because you get to learn how to deal with different spirits.
Shit, before I met y'all, I was a so-called Christian, so I was, you know, kind of in the Bible. Mm-hmm. But then when I met y'all, because, I used to read scriptures, and I didn't know what it meant. Then when I met y'all, then the same scriptures I read, you know what I'm saying?
That's right.
Hey, look, I got a scripture. 2 Corinthians 10:7. Do ye look on things after the outward appearance? If any man trust in himself that he is Yahweh's size, let him of himself think his again, that as he is Yahweh's size, even we are Yahweh's size. You know, you ain't supposed to look on outward appearance, right? 1 Samuel 16:7. But Yahweh said unto Samuel, look not on his countenance or on the height of his stature, because I have refused him. For Yahweh seeth not as man seeth, for man looketh on the outward appearance, but Yahweh looketh on the heart. You know what I mean?
That's right.
On the heart.